on lifecycle management, geographically, and scalability. My name is John Huff, and I'm the StarlingX executive. I'm also a member of the platform of the thousands of edge cards. So bit of an overview of lifecycle at the edge. So we start with the planning and scalable deployment, and we allow the variable configuration model planning. And as the deployments are scalable, as you need to grow, as you scale up, the deployment plan. In terms of deploy, there's a zero touch provisioning that's available. So that's being able to just deploy a remote edge cloud remotely. And managing at the edge, so that means being able to orchestrate lifecycle operations from the system across multiple different clouds. So as you can imagine, we get to hundreds or thousands of edge clouds. We need to be able to orchestrate these operations so that they're not satisfied. The central cloud also provides real-time control and signal payment gaps for glass visibility operations. And during operations, I would perform updates and maintenance operations and configuration changes. So a bit of a view into the distributed cloud itself. So this is the system controller, which the central region, which contains the services and functionalities required to maintain the lifecycle operations at the edge. So these include operations such as software upgrades and updates, firmware programs, firmware updates across the edge, contains container registries for Kubernetes, pods from private models, certificates for security, as well. It also has some shared resources that are distributed across the edge. And a dashboard is available for a graphical user type interface to visit it and storage management as well. So the edge cloud itself, you can see, we can support a heterogeneous model of edge clouds. So here we have two server configuration model with SMX, and here's a standard configuration. And we can deploy additional edge clouds as soon as necessary. And within the edge cloud, also add additional nodes, host installation. The other thing to note is we support either Kubernetes or OpenStack in StarlingX. So both types of deployments are supported. The edge clouds themselves are geographically dispersed, and one key factor affecting its availability of their full clouds, not just workers. So even if this connection was broken for a period of time, the edge clouds can run autonomously. Full master control. And as I mentioned, that was still really nice situation. So here we'll go into one of the steps required for the initial installation. So here we are early in the life cycle. We've just brought up our system controller, and now we'd like to basically deploy an edge cloud. So the system controller is on your app, and the edge cloud server is over here. The only thing that's been done at this point is it's been wired and connected to the network. Otherwise, the operations can be performed remotely. So the Redfish protocol, and Redfish is part of the board management control, which basically allows power management operations reset, as well as selecting which device to prefer. So to start the operation, there's certain challenges, of course, with geographically remote network operations. There's a limited bandwidth typically. There could be data error rates and also play other distance between the sites, latency as well. So I think one of the first steps that we can do is the DC manager will kind of issue a single command. As a user, you would issue a single command that would basically be DC manager self-powered pad. And that would, the correct parameter tell it, in this case, let's say, for example, it could be a simplex configuration. But it's just things like that. The other type of models that we support and installation is better. It's a real time low latency kernel. Even that, now we can configure it post. Upon receiving a command to the network, we'll then mount and fetch the ISO to install the edge cloud from the system controller, which has the resources to do this. But basically, I'm bringing a good image because the interface to Redfish is a low bandwidth one. And so we'll bring in a special image that provides the capability to set up this network for the full image mode. During the installation, which is the next step, they'll pull the OS tree repository over to the edge cloud. And during the bootstrap phase, they'll also pull the container images required for the platform. And at that point, it's deployed ready. And basically, you have your trays for the stack. There is another consideration. This whole cycle can take 75 minutes or so. And one way to reduce that time interval is actually pre-stage some of the operations. So that's the next option that we have is to have a factory installed image with the requisite repository and container images. Having that, basically we will shorten a lot of the installation and container pull times. A lot of those packages are very large. Start the to the application space. It's a similar operation for major release. The difference would be migration at the start. This requires an operational flow change required. Within an edge cloud, I think we touched upon how we do some other types of orchestration. So in this case, just a visual of the operation for the controller, the infrastructure services that we've got, more of a breakdown in terms of how we do. And I can send an RPC request to other services within the node to do the operation. Managing container workloads and the signals that is important for the operation. And in this case, it's a firmware update, so we can just pass it the firmware update for the parties to the firewalls and host and service agent on that host. In the case of firmware, there could be multiple images as well, and they need to be applied in certain signals. So the orchestrator. All part of the module operations after your initial deployment. And finally, in terms of orchestration across multiple edge clouds, this can be initiated by the user to orchestrate a strategy that sends in the proxies to assist some of the data to the DC vault. That sends off a RPC request to another process, the RPC manager orchestrator, which you see is one of the key reports in this right there. And that sends off the REST API request to a KLS secure network, the API network to the edge files. And then from there, that's the orchestration I was just describing. So the edge files could be serving radio power streams. So for example, this is a 5G radio power stream. You have this optimal server that they and it helps pull the required images or update information to the system controller. So in terms of an operational view, the system controller also provides a summary. Demo. loop button. Here, just to go to turn off the wizard for loop, and then you can see this being useful. But basically, what it was trying to show was that the updates can be orchestrated across some clouds, and you have to have hundreds or thousands of clouds so that the updates can be performed as something useful for orchestration. So in terms of challenges to the solutions, so there are a couple of things that we had to overcome, especially when we dealt with scale. So this is a parallel target, not a total target. So this is how many parallel operations can we do at one time for the measurement. So here we have 130,000 for an example. Service monitoring at the system control and at the edge. So basically, services are monitored from edge to edge. And we use the data to monitor what is happening. And we also have, in the event that the entire system is affected, we have backup to store the disaster monitoring control. StarlingX is it's adhering to many open standards, so open source, for instance, different application tools. And it's deployed cloud native with any source StarlingX or the stack. It's compatible with many applications. So this is a view at the outset. Starting X or considering a document. covered. Also our coordinator is